Hey, Vincent here. I'm the Geo Dude. I build up all my geos. I continue my journey and maximize all my geos before any other character. This is going to be a tag team video where I give my thoughts on the pairs between Albedo and all the other geos. I got all my geos to level 80 or higher along with their respective weapons with pretty good or decent artifacts, and most of the talents are level 5 and higher. Zhongli and Albedo. 5-star Geo Duel. They both have RNG particle regeneration. So what I do is I maximize that chance by landing as many hits as I can with the elemental skill. So I want to drop them like a summoner. Since they both have 4-second cooldown for the elemental skill, you can swap to one another and spam the elemental skill. You may have a little small window in between where you may just switch to a third character, or you can just give it a quick whack to activate the bloom if the pillar didn't do so already. And since they're 5-star, they have longer casting time for the elemental burst. And by having a cutscene, they will have more iframes. The longer cast time also allows you to have your elemental skill cooldowns be shortly done, shortly after. And even though their energy particles are generated randomly, I tend to get energy pretty quick. Sometimes lower, sometimes quick, but most of the time it's pretty quick. And the pillars do proc every 2 seconds for Zhongli. And the blooms trigger only 2 seconds as well on hit. So Zhongli does keep and make sure the blossom gets triggered while you're running around dodging stuff, so that they can make sure that the blossom will get triggered. And when you're maxed out on pillars, you can just hold cast to get a Jade Shield, right? Unless you have C2, of course. And but then Zhongli will be out of commission for like 12 seconds doing their elemental skill. But yeah, they both have energy ultimates of 40 seconds, which is pretty good. So you can like pretty quickly ult spam as well. Geo Traveler and Albedo, the Geo Swordy duel. At times, Albedo will give you a lot of energy, but of course it's not consistent. Geo Traveler, on the other hand, gives more consistent energy. So this is not RNG. You get 8-second rocks, 4-second flowers. They both do pretty good damage when you drop them, when you drop the flower and drop the rock. And you can spam those for DPS, and in between you get a few hits in to trigger the blossoms if you haven't, or you can switch into the third character to come in. Geo Traveler tend to have a higher attack modifier, so if you want to do a normal charge attack, I would use the Traveler over the Albedo. And one thing to be wary is, since the Traveler does have a lot of Geo Constructs, you need to be careful where you place your flowers. You can use the hold button to place it wherever you want, though, but of course that takes a little time off your game, right? The radius of the rock balls and the waves are pretty decent, and they're usually within the flowers range to proc the blossoms. So take that as you will. Noelle and Albedo. Geo Flower Duel, there are times where you get that Noelle ultimate pretty quick, and sometimes you gotta wait a bit. To help out with this during Noelle sweeping time, I usually swap to Albedo to do a quick redrop of the flower for a hit and a reset of the bloom proc, and I switch back to Noelle to continue the sweep. Noelle does attack kinda slow, so most of the hit she does get the extra blossom damage. And most of the time, you will have Noelle out attacking and then just drop the flower when the cooldown's done for Albedo to get more chance for energy proc. Ningguang and Albedo. To complement Geo Duel, with Ningguang as the main DPS currently for the Geos, you can just drop Albedo's flower and then have Ningguang do some extra damage. If you have C1, the AoE damage will proc more blooms. Most of the time, you will have Ningguang out and then you swap to Albedo to do a quick drop. And then you can cycle through Ningguang's attack string and then keep swapping to Albedo to get the extra drop damage and refresh the flower. They don't get in the way of each other too much. Ningguang got her own energy regeneration and she wants to be out dealing damage. Albedo supports with the flower and blossom for bonus damage. Albedo is a pretty solid support. You can pair him up with any Geo character and improve them with more ult spam or extra damage from blossom, while giving them energy per particle as they're both Geo. His flower drop does do pretty good damage as well. Zhongli and Albedo both have short summoning elemental skill cooldown, which makes it fun to spam, and ultimate feels nice. But their main roles are supports. Geo Traveler and Albedo to feel a little segregated. I'm not sure if this is because they're both Geo Swordies. I didn't feel a real synergy between them. Noelle and Albedo feels nice as Albedo just makes Noelle swing for more damage, but Noelle do need a more proper battery to maximize her potential. Ningguang and Albedo do seem pretty fitting as Ningguang is the DPS and Albedo is support, and Ningguang has the AoE screen, right? And possible AoE attack to hit for more blossoms. Unlike Noelle, there's no timer to switch back and forth, so you can freely do whatever, and Ningguang have her own energy regeneration. But those are my thoughts as a true Geodude. Hopefully you guys enjoy my opinion. Give this video a like and a comment. What do you guys think? I do stream Genshin on Twitch, so check out my socials down below. And subscribe for more Genshin content. And with that, later days. He's rising? How is it? Who needs fire?
Give up. Submit.